स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर बेटा. एक्चुअली स्टूडेंट्स, दिस लेक्चर इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर क्लास 10. एक्चुअली वी आर थिंकिंग द विच शुड बी द न्यू चैप्टर, एंड यू ऑल नो बिकॉज ऑफ सम शेड्यूल प्रॉब्लम द लास्ट 3 days आई कुड नॉट अपलोड एनी वीडियो. दैट्स वाई, एंड ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ यूर वोटिंग ऑल्सो, the team has decided now we are going to start a short chapter that will be completed within 2-3 lectures only. Okay, by NCERT extra questions we will discuss in later videos. Okay, so class 10, be ready beta. We are going to start a new chapter which is not too much linked with any previous lecture, previous chapters. Okay beta, so we are going to start our new chapter, chapter number 10. Okay, so everyone be ready with the book, notebooks and pen in your hand. Okay, so without any delay beta, the lecture is going to be very short. In 3-4 lectures my target is to complete the chapter, so everyone be regular and be ready. See, the chapter number 10, this is for class 10 beta, this is for class 10th. Okay, the chapter's name is circles. The chapter's name is circles. Very, very, very interesting topic, beta. Very interesting. One of my favorite topics. See, what is a circle? First of all, if we discuss about the circle, we should know what is a circle. What is a circle? See, beta, let me explain first of all the basic about the chapter, and then you will all learn about the we will learn about all the questions. See beta, what is a circle? What is a circle? See, let me give you a basic example. See, suppose this is the point O. Suppose this is the point O, and I asked one student, please find a point A which is 5 cm away from O. The student took the scale, put here, and after measuring 5 cm distance, he told me, sir, this point A is 5 cm away from O. Are you getting my point? I asked to find a point which is 5 cm away from O. He used the scale, he or she, the student used the scale, put like this, and told, sir, this is the point A which is 5 cm away from O. Okay, this is 5 cm away. Then I asked him, find another point which is 5 cm away. He marked a point B here, and then a point C here. And in the same way, can you imagine, will he or she reach here? Yes or no? No, because this distance is very much larger than this distance. Yes or no? OC is larger than OA. We can easily observe. Yes or no? That's why now understand how he will plot the points. He will take the scale and plot the points like this. Sir, these are the points which are 5 cm away from O. These are the points which are 5 cm away from O. Okay. This example states what? Try to understand better. What does this example state? It states that, can you imagine, can you feel that the point, collection of these points is forming a shape of circle, yes or no? Yes or no? Got my point? What does it mean? It means circle is the collection of points. Collection of points which are equidistant from a fixed point. Okay, you got my point? What is circle? Again, once again, I am explaining beta. What was the activity done? It was asked to find all the possible points which are at a fixed distance from O, or you can say the distance is 5 cm. If we try to find all the points which are 5 cm away from O, we will move like this. Yes or no? And a circle will be formed. It means, what is a circle? Circle is the collection of points. Which are equidistant from a fixed point. Got my point, beta? Now see, what is this fixed point called as? This is called as center. And this equal distances, are called as radius. Yes or no? Are you getting my point? What is a circle? Circle is the collection of points which are equidistant from a fixed point. Done, beta? And this fixed point is known as center. And this distance is known as radius. Done? All the points of the this boundary, all the points on this boundary are called as circular points, or you can say circumferential points. Why? Because these points are forming the circle, therefore these are circular points. Okay, beta, let me rub the board and then I will explain little bit more about the circle. Then we will, without any delay, move towards the chapter. Okay, some terminology are associated with circle, beta. Some terminology is associated with circle, like this is circle, yes or no? Boundary is called as circumference. Yes or no? I think you all are aware of this because you are in 10th class. Okay, what is this? Center. Done, beta? What is this distance? Radius. This distance is radius. Any line segment joining two points of circumference. Is known as chord. Yes or no? Sorry. What is chord? Chord is the line segment that joins the two points on the circumference, okay? This is chord, chord. These all are chords. But if you observe, the chord which is passing through center is longest. Yes or no? This is called as diameter. In other words, you can say the longest chord of the circle is diameter. The chord which is passing through center is diameter. Then, okay, now see, suppose this is the circle, this is the point, these are two points on circumference. This portion is called as arc, yes or no? This portion is also called as arc. But this is small, therefore this is minor arc. Larger one is major arc, okay? Slowly, slowly, as the questions will appear, according to them, I will explain each and every term, okay? So do not worry about anything. No fear when I am here, okay? Now students, beta, I am directly jumping towards the topic. Because this is enough, circle, about circle you all have learnt in earlier classes. That's why I'm not taking too much time on the basics. Okay, beta, now see, what if we start circle? See, beta, relation of a circle with a line. When a line is related with circle, a pair of line and circle is taken, how many terms are there? See, beta, suppose this is the circle and this is the line. This is one pair, line and circle. Another pair, beta, circle, a line. सेकंड, थर्ड पेयर, थर्ड पेयर लाइन विद सर्कल. ओके, यू गॉट माय पॉइंट? सी एवरीवन, वेरी सिंपल इज दैट द टर्मिनोलॉजी अबाउट दीज लाइन. सी, इफ यू सी हियर, लाइन इज नॉट मीटिंग द सर्कल एट एनी पॉइंट. लाइन इज नॉट मीटिंग द सर्कल एट एनी पॉइंट. दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज कॉल्ड एज नॉन इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन. नॉन इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन. ओके, हेयर द पॉइंट लाइन इज मीटिंग द सर्कल ओनली एट वन पॉइंट. ओनली एट वन पॉइंट. सपोज दिस इज पी. ओनली एट वन पॉइंट बेटा. इट मीन्स द लाइन इज टचिंग द सर्कल एट यूनिक पॉइंट. ओके, इन दिस केस लाइन इज कॉल्ड एज टेंजेंट. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज टेंजेंट. There is an interesting story about the naming of these and these lines. Okay, first we will complete the chapter, then whenever we get some extra time, I will definitely tell you the story about tangent and the secant. Okay, see, here if you see, the line is meeting the circle at two points. The circle at two points. In this case, the line is called as secant. In this case, the line is called as secant. See, beta, all these pair are very, very, very important and having its own role in the chapter. See, the point where the tangent is touching the circle is known as point of contact. Point of contact. Yes or no? Done, beta? Take the screenshot of this. Done. Now next terms beta, which we have to use in here. See beta, the mostly chapter, the questions, mostly questions in the chapter are related to tangents. So you can say the majority of the questions will be associated with the tangents. Now see, suppose this is a circle. Can I draw a tangent of this like this? Yes or no? One tangent, another tangent, third tangent, four, five, and so on. In other words, I want to ask, how many tangents can a circle have? Please tell me, how many tangents can a circle have? Infinite tangents, beta. Infinite tangents can a circle have. Okay, why? Because infinite points are there on the circumference of the circle, therefore infinite tangents can be drawn. Okay, from a point a single tangent can be drawn. Okay, then infinite tangents can be drawn to a circle. Okay, then see, if you observe now, see, just feel it beta. Suppose this is a circle. Later on I will prove it also. Later on, I will prove it also according to the chapter. Now see, this is a circle. Suppose I am drawing a tangent T1. A tangent T1. And I want to draw another tangent parallel to T1. Are you getting my point? Here is the tangent is T1. And I want to draw another tangent which is parallel to T1 like this. Yes or no? Done, beta. Here if you observe, is it possible to draw any other tangent which is parallel to this? Is it possible? See, beta, this is not parallel to these two. This is not parallel to these two. Whatever is the condition, very frankly, you can observe by practical, if I draw a line like this, but this is not the tangent. Are you getting my point? At one time, only two tangents can be parallel at the most. A circle can have two parallel tangents at the most. Okay, beta? These are two, three things I discussed which will help you in exercises. Now, everyone take out your NCERT 10.1, page number 209. See, first question. Everyone see the first question. How many tangents can a circle have? You all know, just 2 minutes before I explained a circle can have infinite tangents. Yes or no? Then, what does it mean? All that theory is asked here. Do not worry, each point will be cleared. Question number two. I don't think it is to be right here, na? Answer one, answer two. You can all do by yourself. Question number two, fill in the blanks. First part, a tangent to a circle, intersect it in how many points? See, beta, a tangent to a circle meets circle at how many points? One point. Okay? It is not intersecting. You can say it is meeting the circle at one point. Done? We have discussed this in earlier lecture, just earlier introduction. A circle, second beta, a line intersecting circle in 2 points. See, line intersecting circle in 2 points is known as secant. Yes or no? This also we have discussed. A line meeting the circle at 2 points is secant. Number three, a circle can have dash parallel tangents at the most. I just discussed, beta, if we draw the parallel tangents for a circle, only 2 tangents can be parallel at the most. A circle can have 2 parallel tangents at the most at one time. Okay, done. Now are you getting my point? What was my introduction? Introduction was totally related to 10.1 questions. Okay, now see, question number two, part fourth, the common point of a tangent and the circle, everyone make some noise, beta, you all know this, the common point of tangent and circle is called as point of contact, yes or no, beta. Done? Sure? See, beta, this lecture I have made very small only to introduce chapter 10. Okay? So that right now I am going to give you this lecture. That's why I kept this lecture too short. Okay? Do not worry. From the next video lectures, you will get detailed study of all the chapter. Okay? So, okay, beta, have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe. One more thing, like the videos, share the videos, and please give positive comments. Have a nice day, beta. Done.